Hi everyone, welcome back to Engineers Tech Up channel. This is Mohit. In this session we will learn how to handle multiple drop down. So be having the scenario, you have to display the list of the drop down. Then how to display list of the drop down? So we can see in this session. So just I will give you some overview of that code, and after that we will execute that code in our system. Okay, so let me check this which code I have to. Yes, so here we having this code. So after that I will also execute this code on the system. Okay, so let me first I'll explain you later. So first we will move on the practical part, then after that also I will explain parallelly. Okay, so that is good for us. So just give me a 1 second. So I'm going to my package. So just I'm going to write from the starting. So if you are very new in Selenium, so please refer my previous video. In the previous video I have mentioned over there, you know, how to launch the browser and all. But if you are, you know, not a beginner, then you guys are able to understand. And if you are the beginner, I will again explain. So first I will provide the exe file location. So bev driver dot chrome dot driver. Okay, here I will pass the exe file location. So if you are very new in Selenium, so just refer my previous video and definitely you will having the more, you know, understanding regarding this. Because in this session I'm not going to explore how to launch the browser and all, just I'm going to explain how to display multiple, you know, if you having the drop down and how to display this. Okay, so the steps first, just I'm going to launch the browser. So and after that we will also learn how to make the reusable method driver equal to new Chrome driver. So in this video agenda is how to display multiple drop down. Then after that you can take any URL. So in my local I having the one piece of the dummy code, so I will go through that HTML code and you guys can take any example from website or anywhere. But just we will learn the concept here. So in HTML doc, so what we are going to discuss, we are going to discuss in this session, this is the scenario. So this is your UI page, and this UI page you have to display the months, complete months for all this drop down. So you have to inspect this again. I will come on I will jump on this page. So now you have to pass the URL here, right? So we can pass the URL here. Then I'm going to maximize this browser to driver dot manage dot window dot maximize. Okay, after maximizing, so I'm going to give some weight statement also. Okay, so if you having the a small weight, so we can wait for so driver dot manage dot timeout dot driver dot manage dot timeout dot implicit wait. So I will use implicit wait for waiting for 10 seconds over there. Then I'm going to use a time unit dot second. So this is the common steps. Now steps, what is the other steps? So if you will handle this select tag or select class, and how to handle the select class, so first of all we have to check this is your select tag or not. If select tag is not there, means select class will not work. So our agenda is I want to display this complete list of the, you know, months. So how to display this? So first you have to see the select tag is there or not. If select tag is there, then we will use select class. So let's move on that. So here just going to find the element driver dot find element by dot. So let's see what is the ID of that. So where you are performing the operation, I am performing the operation on this. So first we can find the, you can see we having the name, so we can use directly name. So y dot name, right? Y dot name, and by dot name, and we will return web element. We will store in the web element type. Why we are using this web element type, I will tell you later. Now I'm going to create a class, select class. So if you are new in Selenium, please refer my previous video. Okay, I already discuss regarding this select tag, but no problem at all. So I will again discuss this, you know, how to handle this, you know, multiple. So select is a class which is available in selenium.org OpenQ support.ui package. So this is the independent class. So when you are creating the object of the select class, we have to pass this reference. If you will not pass this reference, then it will not interact with element, right? So now this element is interacted with select class, and now we can access the method which is available in the select class. So we having the method called get options. You can see we having the method of get options, and get options method will return list of the web element, right? So what will happen, it will return list of the web element. So web element and list of the web element. Now list of months, right? So I'm going to give this list of months. Again, this is the list, right? So list is, you know, interface. This is the again part of collection. I will draw one pic so you guys are able to understand what is going to happen. Just I'm going to write the code, then each iteration we will understand how this code is working. Okay, so don't worry about that. So list of the months. Okay, one second, I'll just copy this. Sorry, I have to initialize, right? I was missing this, so that's why this option is not coming when I was typing. And if you will press control or space, all the options will come automatically. Dot size. Size is a method, so it will find the size of this, you know, list. Then again, what I'm going to do here, I greater than equal to, okay, I will write I greater than equal to size. Okay, so now it will go and it will iterate all the element which is available in this list. Now what I'm going to do here, just I will list of, okay, so list dot get. So get is a method, it will iterate all. Now I'm going to also print this all the value in the string format. Okay, so I will store in str equal to. Okay, so now I'm going to print str. Okay, so so if we will press control, then it will come this value. So I'm going to print this. So first we can test this, our code is working or not. Okay, if something went wrong, we will fix it, or if everything is fine, then I will explain to you how this code is working. Okay, so writing the code is not a big deal, but understanding of the code is big deal. And I will explain each line of the code, how this code is working, right? So I can see many video, but nobody can tell you how this all the iteration is working. But in this session, definitely we'll learn how this all the iteration is working. Okay, so I'll do one thing. It's getting out of bound exception. Okay, I 0 0. So let me check. Okay, because I have given I greater than equal to 1, so all the value is going to display. But you can see here size is 5, but I have given equal to, that's why I think it is going to fail. So let me check and let me execute one more time. So let's see what will happen. Okay, so we need to display all the DOV, and let me check. Yeah, now each iteration we are not getting any exception. So let's understand how this code will work. Okay, so this is our output. Okay, so this is our output, and how this output is coming, I'll show you. Complete iteration I will show you. So let's understand how this code is working. Okay, So now what will happen? This is your comma nest up, first line of the code. This is system is a property, sorry, system is a class, and set property is a method. It will accept two parameter, one is your key and one is your value. I am going to use Chrome browser, so key I will pass webdriver.chrome.driver, and value we can pass the exe file for Chrome driver. If you are new in the Selenium, please refer my previous video. Okay, now we having the webdriver driver equal to new Chrome driver. So webdriver is an interface, and this is your Chrome driver. We are going to create a method, sorry, we are going to create a created an object, so we are holding the object. So again, I will tell you what is this webdriver driver equal to new Firefox. I'll just give you one overview of that. So webdriver is an interface, superclass equal to, we are holding subclass, right? So this concept is called upcasting, and this concept is called also polymorphism concept. If you are not aware of this webdriver driver equal to new Firefox, please refer my previous video. I already spent on the time of this for, you know, explaining this. Here, launching the, you know, URL, maximizing and waiting for 10 seconds, right? So picture will start here. So what is the rules for select class? So where you have to perform the operation, you have to find this element. After finding this element, then what will happen? After finding this element, we store element, we have to store in this, right? And return type we have given this, you know, web element type. Why we are giving this web element type? Because if you will go in the select class implementation, then what will happen? This will interact with this element will interact with select class, and we can create an object of the select class, and whatever the operation you want to perform, means whatever the method which is available inside this select class, we can handle, right? So what happened? I'm going to access this method. This method is called get option, and it will return list of the web element. Okay, so what happened here? All the element which is stored inside this list. What is the list? So this is the one type of the collection, and just basics points of the list. You know, it is a global and array. There is no size limitation. You can store n number of times object inside this list, and it is working on the index. Okay, it is working on the index. Then what happened? All the element January, February. So I'll tell you one more thing, right? Inside this object, we are storing the object inside this list. So it will not store object directly in this. So all the object, this is your Jan, and this is your Jan, Feb, March, April. So here one ID is there. This is the, again, Java part. So if you are new in the Java coding, please refer my previous video. I already explained over there how to, you know, list is working internally. So this object will be a store here. 10101011012, like that. So all the value will be a store here when you are writing get option, and this is your referenced variable. List of the month is your reference variable, and holding this all the object. Now this is the zero, right? So how this for loop will work? This for loop will work I equal to zero. So what happened? I equal to zero, then this, what is the size is 5, right? So zero here, the value is 5. Got it, right? So again, it will so first iteration, this is your first iteration initialization. Again, it will check the condition, then it will come here i0 get of text. It will capture the what is the value, then it will return and it will print your fav, right? Again, what will happen? Second iteration will go here, and i will become 1. So 1 greater than 5, again it will come and 1, and it will capture, get method text will capture the element which is present in the web element, and it will return the string type. Okay, so now again it will print fav. So it will iterate how many element or object which is present inside this list, So this is your one interview question, and I will suggest you, while writing the code, if interviewer will not tell you also, can you explain this code, make this diagram, and you have to explain like that. So many people are coming in the interview, right? Why they will select to you? So make yourself unique, okay? Make yourself unique, and definitely, you know what will happen, you having the more understanding. So if you will make the diagram and you have to explain in front of the interviewer, then you know definitely you are, you know, unique over there, okay? So this is, you know, how it is working. So be having the another question, how to make this method reusable. You should not write again and again this line of the code, okay? So I'll show you 1 second. So I have created already one helper class, okay? This is my helper class. I will explain this stuff, okay? So let me, I don't want to write this line of the code. This is common, right? This is common line of the code. So not this one, right? This is a common, again and again you should not write. So I'm just commenting this again. I will explain to you helper class. You guys can create this helper class, and what I can do, just I will extend helper, okay? Helper test, okay? I explain this, I just comment this, and helper test dot app launch. So your question is, what is this app launch? So I will just press control and mouse over here. You can click on this. So this is you know our app launch, right? So here you should not write again and again line of the code, right? So this will help you to, you know, launch all the things. What you have to change, just I need to change this URL because my URL is different. So just go here, and this is the again part of the framework. So people are discussing the part of the framework, but in my session, every topic I'm going to make the reusable, means parallelly you are also having the concept of the real time, how the people are working in the real time, right? So in my training session, I'm completely providing, you know, like you guys are working in the startup company or real time. So now you should not write. You can see, this is coding a standard. This is coding a standard, how we can work on that, right? So you should not write again and again this line of the code completely. Just you can call this method and you should not write again and again. So now I want to also make this method is reusable. So if I did not make it, then I will make it, yeah. So I already written this method is reusable, how to use this, okay? So just I want to explain here. So I have created one method that is called a static method, and I'm going to pass here web element type, and again I have created a, you know, select class, again passing this reference variable. See, whatever the steps we having over there, just I have made the common. You can directly use this method to any operation if you having this display the list of the element, right? So you can see what is the, you know, return type is web element type, right? So web element type. So I can call this directly. You can see again, I have created get option. I'm passing the same thing I have repeated, but here this is your reusable method. If you understood my this code, same thing I have written over there, but that is common. So what I have to do, simply I will call here helper class. If you are not able to understand, just reach out to me. Again, I will explain to you what you are not able to understand. But if you are having the basics knowledge of the Java, definitely you are able to understand. So what is the method name? Get options, right? Get options. Method name, let me cross check. No, this is the list of the drop down. Okay, so this is the our method, list of the drop down. So let me, okay, so this is your list of the drop down, and this element I can pass it, and you should not write this line of the code again and again. So this is the beauty in our session. You know, you can see many tutor are there, okay, but they are only going to tell you the process how to do that. But in my session, I all the whatever the topics we are going to discuss, we are learning parallelly, you know, how to make the reusable method. So here you should not write again this line of the code. Okay, this code is reusable. This is, you know, readable. You know, we having the less line of the code, and we can, you know, how we can make it. So again, you can just look into this. I have did same thing, but I have made it the static method, passing this parameter, creating a object of the select class, a storing all the element in the list, iterating all the value using the for loop, and getting all this value and printing this value and returning the element type. So this is, you know, how to make the reusable method. But I will recommend you, if anyone will ask in the interview, you can make the reusable method, but first you can execute the simple steps. Okay, so let me execute this code and let's see it is working or not. Some error is coming. What is this error? Okay, so let me remove this, because this for loop, you know, we have removed this, right? So let me run this, and we are not closing this browser, so coming session I will also close this browser. Okay, so let's see our output. See, we are getting the same output. So this is the beauty of, you know, how you can make the reusable method. Okay guys, so I think you learn something new. And why we are making this video, because of this, you know, how to make, you know, reusable method, how to make the functionality while working in your real time. Okay, so my agenda is how to develop the functionality. So you guys can try with another drop down or other scenario to create this, right? So I will give you one, you know. So you have to display day, you have to display year. So you guys can take this, this is my local, it is not deploying the any server. So what you can do, you can take any website and try to display this day, try to display it with year, right? So just I'm going to close this session. Hope you guys will like this video, and please share. I will definitely make the another video for your reusable and next topic. So here you are learning the framework part also. So thank you so much, and we will see you in the next lecture. Please, if you really helpful, like if you are watching for this video, subscribe my channel, share with your friend, and if you having the any doubt, please comment below. Definitely I will reply you back. Thank you so much.